Christmas. Today I'll be showing you how to make plum cake. Let's start. You should take a bowl. To this you should add 3 tablespoons of tutti frutti, 3 tablespoons of black raisin, 3 tablespoons of roughly chopped cherries, roughly 3 tablespoons of roughly chopped cashew nuts, 3 tablespoons of roughly chopped almonds, and 3 tablespoons of raisins. Now give this a nice stir, and to this approximately you should add 6 tablespoons of orange juice. Now stir it again. These dry fruits should soak the orange juice. Let it soak for 1 hour. It will be very good if it can soak for 3 to 4 hours. Now I have taken a kadhai. You should add 6 tablespoons of sugar. The flame should be low and the sugar should start melting. The sugar should melt and it should turn brown. Now you can see that the sugar has melted and it has turned brown. So now you should add 3 to 4 tablespoons of warm or hot water. Now transfer this caramelized sugar syrup into a bowl and let it cool down completely. Now let's prepare the batter. Take a bowl. In that add 1 cup of milk, 6 tablespoons of oil, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon powder, and 1/4 teaspoon of dried ginger powder. Now give this a good stir. Now sieve 2 cups of maida, 1/2 cup of powdered sugar, 1 tablespoon of cocoa powder, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, and 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. Sift them all together. After sieving all the ingredients, give it a nice stir. Now add the caramelized sugar syrup and mix it well again. Mix it well. If you do not get the correct consistency, then you can add some milk. Now you can see that we have got the correct consistency. So now you should add 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence and give it a nice stir. Now add the dry fruits which we soaked in orange juice and mix it again. Mix it gently. Now you should add 1 teaspoon of vinegar. You should mix it very quickly and put it into the cake mold. Here I have taken a cake tray and I have lined it with some butter paper. You can grease it with some oil or butter also. Now pour the batter into it. Now you should tap it a little bit so that all the air bubbles are popped. Now you can decorate the cake with some cashew nuts. You should preheat the oven at 180 degree for 10 minutes. You should bake this cake at 180 degree for 30 minutes in the oven. Now the cake is in the oven. Now you should check that the cake has baked properly with a skewer or a toothpick. Now poke it into the cake. If it is totally clean, that means that it has baked properly. If you see some batter on the skewer, then you can bake it for 5 more minutes. You should let this cool down completely. Now you can see how nicely the cake has turned out. I will cut one piece and show how the texture is inside. You can see how spongy the cake is, and this cake is totally eggless. Please give this recipe a try. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye.